Hello guys, my name is Willem and welcome to LRDX Cars. Today I'm at the Ford Village here in Leopoldsburg in Belgium to check out some cool Fords. Like you can see behind me, the latest Ford Mustang. And yeah, hopefully we'll see some cool Fords, a lot of Focus RSs I expect. Of course, also a lot of Mustangs. Maybe, hopefully, fingers crossed, we'll see even a Ford GT or something like that. Of course, also a lot of ST models like the Fiesta ST and the Focus ST. Yeah, like you can see, we'll line up. I will show to you, and yeah, we'll see what the day brings. Enjoy watching. And before I start the video, I want to say to all of you that are watching or that are regular watchers, please subscribe on the channel. Because yeah, now I'm it's my job now making the video. So I hope a lot of you will subscribe and follow the channel, because I have a lot of cool things planned in the coming months. We'll be going to San Francisco, to Monterey Car Week in August. In June, I will be going to Italy, to the Ferrari Museum and to the Pagani Museum. So yeah, a lot of cool videos to come. Also in September, I'll be going to the St. Moritz Car Week. Also a whole week of car events. So yeah, a lot of cool things to come, guys. Please subscribe on the channel, and yeah, today a lot of Fords, so for the Ford guys, enjoy watching. Now you can see the first car that was standing behind me is this, in a very cool, I think, sort of cherry red exterior color of latest Ford Mustang, also the convertible version. Since Ford came with the EcoBoost engine, I see them a lot here in Belgium or in Europe even, because yeah, before only the V8s were produced and the V6s, and yeah, the efficiency and also, yeah, the fuel consumption and things like that. That's, yeah, the car wasn't allowed in Europe. But now, yeah, you see them a lot. This even is the latest updated model. Like you can see on the headlights. Sort of new design of headlights, which are a bit sharper, a bit smaller. Like you can see even an extra air intake to cool the front wheel arches and the brakes, of course. Then, of course, the big front grille of the Mustang GT with a nice Mustang in the horse, and of course you can see even underneath an extra air intake, and you can see through the big radiator. This model will probably have the 4-cylinder engine, the turbocharged 4-cylinder engine, and you can see even some extra coolings on the engine bonnet. I think this are the more standard design of brakes and wheels. I think you can also go for a more upgraded version. Very cool, this car. Very much like the exterior color. And now you can see the all new interior, also with a virtual cockpit behind. And like this model is the automatic, of course. And yeah, the Mustang has also the rear seats, which is also very handy. You can take your friends or your children with you. Yeah, very cool car, and yeah, we'll walk further on the cool cars that we have here today. Old model of Fiesta Turbo. I need to check myself if there are Recaro seats inside, but yeah, like you can see, the old car still looks very good. The air outlets on the engine bonnet, even the latches to get the full engine bonnet off. Very cool looking car with the yellow lights underneath. Then we have this, I think is the latest model of Ford Fiesta ST. So driving when I was coming to here on my bike, because yeah, a lot of you won't know, but I recently sold the car, like I told in the couple of videos ago, because yeah, now I'm fully focused in on the channel, and I think this is the very latest model. I can see the rally inspired sort of latches to stop dirt from going on the beautiful car. You can see this owner even opted for some yellow fog lights underneath, which look yeah quite good. I think you can see it in the headlight design, because yeah, you now have the LED stripe inside in the latest model. Before, yeah, it was a bit different. And yeah, the coolest part I think on the ST models is of course the grille, nice mesh grille, nice hexagonal shape in it, very cool look. Also the upgraded wheel design this car has, with a sort of Y shape in, very cool. This is the owner, if you're interested. Some carbon finishes, no, the red engine start button, yeah, yeah, then behind it is a little bit of carbon fiber. Of course the tinted windows, and like you can see this owner even up, I think for an even bigger spoiler than standard. You can see, very big spoiler lip. Very cool looking car. Then next to it is another, I think it's a Focus ST. But like you can see this, this owner went a bit wild with it. Full new look on it. I think he also has driven the Nürburgring with it. Because yeah, this is the little plaque of the Nürburgring with the ST in. New Ford badge and even. Very cool, full new underlip. With even some carbon fiber finishes, very cool. Yeah, we really like it. And then like you can see, even went for a bit wider wheel arches. More extended wheel arches would give a very aggressive look to it. Like you can see the whole side skirt of the car is also in carbon fiber, which is yeah quite nuts on a Ford model. And then with the also the banana, as he calls this, the banana car, with the banana on the wheels and the yellow inside. Yeah, very cool looking car. Even the carbon finish on the mirrors and the roof, where you can see the Nürburgring. Yeah, I think this owner will be going to the Nürburgring with it a lot. And then I don't know how this guy is called. I can't come up for it for now, but yeah, it's funny. And then the carbon fiber striping on the car. Even the door handles with a nice finish. I think it's more of a wrap, but yeah, it's still cool. Also the rear wheel arch is a bit extended. Then he has gone for some Bulex exhaust systems. Yeah, of course, for a much better sound. Little pops and bangs I will expect. I think he's the chemical guy, so yeah, go to the Instagram or something like that, even the Ford badge is a bit different, the ADAS tuning of the ST. Yeah, very cool looking car this one. The next to it is a Ford Focus RS. I think probably the next to the Ford GT, the coolest car you can have in the Ford performance lineup. This in the sort of, yeah, what is the blue color called? Sort of Smurf blue color with a nice full matte black roof, even the matte black spoiler, and the very big exhaust, very big round exhaust on each side, and sort of still sort of diffuser with the fins in, the fog light. I think this model will produce about 400 horsepower, this Focus RS model. You can see the Brembo brakes. And the sort of matte finish on the wheels, not the gloss black, but more the matte black finish on the wheels. Very cool looking car. Then, I don't know if it's standard, but maybe it's on the latest model, but this front air intake, front grille, looks a bit different to me, I think. I think the owner has gone for some changes with it. Very big radiator underneath and even up, yeah, we can see all air intakes, also on the side of the car air intake. Of course, cool the brakes. Yeah, very cool looking car this one. Very much like it. And then if you take a quick look on the interior, you can see another one of those guys. Also the Recaro seats, nice blue finish on. This car is a manual, of course. Yeah, good looking car. I think it will be a nice sound it will make. Nice pair these two. Dan komen we to another very cool pair hier at the Ford Village in Leopoldsburg. I think this one is the latest Focus model. You can see it on the headlights. Full new design of headlights, but also with the LED striping in. Then you can see underneath and above the three lights in. Very cool look to it. Then I think this owner also went for an extended front lip. Yeah, you can see the gloss black front lip isn't standard, I think. I think these are also colored with a more black back or maybe aftermarket. Nice SD wedge in. Very cool looking car. And next to it, you can see the RS500, one of the most special. Then you can see the baby S wheels. Also, of course, aftermarket wheels. They give a nice sporty look to this car. New Focus look. I think the car is also a bit put down. It's also nice interior, SD, even the numbering B221 it says. I think it's maybe a first edition model, also with nice Recaro seats in. What I like in the Ford models, that they have the Recaro seats. Very cool, and if you come to the back of this car, you can see also the full new lights of the Ford Focus. And then, yeah, I was already expecting that. Mount tuner, very known Ford tuner. I know the guys who follow Schmi will also know that his Ford Focus was tuned by Mount Tune. And like you can see, also the sort of diffuser, even more aggressive than the Focus RS next to it. Very cool looking car, this one. Also with the two big exhausts. Yeah, very cool looking car, this one. The sunroof, I think. Yes, very cool. And then we have something very, very special here. I was hoping that we could see a car like this today. This is the RS500 model. Like the name says, there are only 500 of built worldwide. It was about the latest phase of this generation of the Ford Focus RS. And yeah, now that one is the most recent, but yeah, of this model of Focus, they won't be making any RS models, which is a bit sad. I think that they will keep continuing to build the ST models, but yeah, the RS models weren't that popular or weren't sold that much, and also because of the standards, I think the CO2 emissions and the fuel consumption and things like that. And yeah, everything here in Europe is getting a bit too strict, I think. And yeah, that's why they won't be building any RS models. So that model will be the last one of the RSs. I think the price of those will probably still be very good, or keep themselves very good. Yeah, this is a very cool car. I was driving it even on the Gran Turismo games. And the full matte black exterior, it's typical for the RS500, so you can only have them with the matte black color. And yeah, I was saying, like the name says, 500 models, but this car owns also has 500 horsepower. So for a hatchback car that probably weighs less than 1500 kilos, has 500 horsepower, guys. It's, I think even the standard 911 does not have 500 horsepower, yeah, so this is crazy. And some special features that you can recognize on the Ford Focus RS500 are of course the air outlets on the engine bonnet, and then the very big air intake also underneath of the car where the radiator is put. Then this owner, I think, also went to Mount Tune with it because of the M, and the E also has some extra air intakes here that, if I'm not wrong, will go to the front wheel arch just to cool them. But yeah, very cool aggressive look this car, also with the extended wheel arches from standard. Come to the side, the cool RS design of wheels, S500, nice red brakes. And yeah, the mount tune again, the RS, very cool. Take a quick look on the inside. See, very beautiful Alcantara en leather. Combination of the inner and Alcantara and the outside and leather. Nice red leather. You can also see a full roll cage behind. I don't know if you guys can see it. I think this owner will probably be taking it on track. I don't know if you can see it, but this car is number 256 of the 500. So yeah, really numbered cars. Always cool to have your own number. Ford Racing, of course. And the also very big spoiler of the car. Looks not standard if you compare it to the car next to it. This one is very high. Of course, you put a lot of downforce on the car. But yeah, this car is four-wheel driven. But yeah, the most of the power will, of course, go to the rear wheels. And yeah, you will probably need all the downforce on the rear. And yeah, you can see also not that standard exhaust. I think the owner also went for some mountain exhausts. They're even bigger, I think, than the... I can even put my hand in, like you can see. Very big. And then the shark fins of the diffuser. Very cool. See again the mountain on the rally inspired sort of third stoppers. Yeah, very cool looking car, this one. I prefer even, I think, this generation of the Ford Focus RS. We have another model of RS, the latest, but I think I even prefer this model and of course this RS 500. Probably the coolest to have in the Ford lineup. Maybe the Ford GT is cooler, but yeah, the price will probably 10 times higher. So yeah, I think this one is probably the coolest car for the money. Also, because it's a numbered car and yeah, the performance it has. I'm gonna ask on the owner now how the Mountune performance did upgrade the car. I will tell you in a minute. Then, if we walk further, we have another latest RS model. I was talking to the owner of the RS 500, like I was saying. And he said the car had 390 horsepower. A little bit extra from Mountune. And I was wrong. I said to you guys that the RS 500 model had already the four-wheel drive system. But in this model, they only had the four-wheel drive system. That car, RS 500, only had the front-wheel drive. And the owner knew, of course, a lot about the Ford, and he said this four-wheel drive system is also very fun to drive, that you have the drift mode. You can put 70% of the power to the rear wheels, which makes it very fun on track and some twisty roads. Pretty much like this color of this model, with the gold wheels also. Just yeah, very nice, nice manual car. So yeah, hopefully in the future, maybe, you can even drive in one. Ja, next to it. More standard focus. We have another Mustang hier. Also the latest Mustang. This one in a very cool yellow color. More of a mustard yellow color. Nice spoiler on. I think it's also the EcoBoost model. Some subtle changes this owner has done is an extra lip top of the spoiler. And then these, sort of retro inspired. Sort of air outlets. And then an extra on the side even. Very cool. Nice wheel design this car has. Yeah, the Mustang is also a very good looking car, I think. For the money, I think probably one of the best. Then next to it, another cool Fiesta. Some air outlets on the bonnet. Of course, a lot of tuning here. Like this car, which looks quite funny, I think. So fully tuned. Then a nice wrapped one. Nice white one, little glimpse. And this is a V8 model. That's why it's open. Mustang GT, not the EcoBoost engine. The real V8. Very cool look. A big air intake also, this car. We don't have the horns inside. Another, I think it's an aftermarket grill. It's owner went for. Very cool look. Also the striping runs over the car. If you have the 5-liter sign on the side, it says that is the V8 model. Also the Brembo brakes, very cool car. Also the striping on the sides en de hoed. Zo'n nader spoiler, dus zo'n moment voor. Wat een standaard spoiler, cool striping. Nice. Very much like the lights, rear lights. I think it's also a special look you went for with a chrome on the side of that. Also some aftermarket exhaust. Very cool. That was nice sound this V8 will make. Then next to it, we have another Mustang. And then they can see. If we compare it with the yellow one we just saw and the other, the latest one, we have more the more pie lights, and this was the first time, or the first EcoBoost Europe car with that came to Europe with that other design of lights, and yeah, this owner went for a full tune, like you can see, even the paint at the inside of the engine bonnet, some sort of ram in front, or yeah, tow bar, which looks very cool, very aggressive. Even an extra carbon fiber lip on the side of the car with some fins. All the nice red detailings. Then if you look on the inside, everything is red, I think. Which is a quite special look. Even an R8. I think an extra air cooler. Nice, the Mustang bar. Very cool. Yeah. Nice carbon finish even. Also the special wheel design with the pink inside. Nice Ford performance stickers, also the air outlets. Also in the interior even. Some wrapped carbon fiber, yeah, looks very cool. Very aggressive spoiler even. Also the extra fins on the rear window. Very cool. A nice full carbon fiber. Also a Kropovich exhaust. Very cool. Good looking car, this one. All the stickers. Very nice. Then we have a more standard model with the black striping overneath, more silver one. To compare it with the other ones, yeah, this one is much standard look, also the EcoBoost, I think. Yeah, but yeah, still cool car, this one. You can compare this one with more lighter lights, more the white smoked out lights. You can also go for the red rear lights. But yeah, the Mustang, very cool car. If you go further, you have some tuned cars here. There is tuning going on this car. Very cool. And another nice tuned Focus RS. Full new from Revo, I think. New air cooler and things like that. Maybe even a new turbocharger. Also a new lip, full carbon fiber lip. This car has a very cool look. Yeah, like it that the Ford community like the tuning also. Other design of wheels on the OZ Racing. Yeah, very cool. And on the side skirt even, continuous carbon fiber. Very cool. Even the diffuser has changed a bit. Very cool. Also another rear light design. The tuned Fiesta hier. Tuned Mondeo hier. Yeah, cool. But they tune the cars a bit. This one has special design of wheels, very cool. if the latest Mustang, the electric one, which I will be reviewing in the not the distant future, also a test drive and things like that will be coming with the Mustang lights. Yeah, it's a bit strange that they called their EV their electric car the Mustang, but yeah, it's sort of to attract more young people, I think. And yeah, why not? So some not standard wheels on this Fiesta. We go further on the other side. Very cool, another tuned Fiesta here. We have a glimpse here also by Mount Tune. A lot of tuning here by Mount Tune going on. Not that standard wheels, of course. Sort of RS from bumper. So a lot of changes on the side, we see on the rear even. Full new rear lights, also the RS spoiler. I think this probably will be an RS model, I think. Yeah. You have here Fiesta also. This is also a fun car. Ford car. Cabrio model. I think it's an Escort or something like that. Yeah, nice. This Fiesta also has the extended lip in the front. Nice. Some work horses from Ford, even a fire truck from Ford, even a camper van with a full tent on top. Ford, and this is a more extreme hard work van. Like, you can see the full style look to it, which looks quite nice. Another work house is more bakery bus with something very special inside. So nice to take a look at. We built to put your bike in. It looks quite nice. More of a hot bike. Yeah. Nice Fiesta leaving. Nice Fiesta sound. This Fiesta ST is also not that standard exhaust system. It's also the Miltec exhaust. And that Escort also very cool. We just saw one cabrio model. If you go further, another Escort here, the Turbo RS model. It also not that standard exhaust. Nice sound here from the Ford. Hey, so good looking. Interior kept in good condition, I think. Yeah. You can see the engine compartment looks very clean. I think it's also more of a tuned car, this one. The Escort Cabrio NL group. Another RS model here. One of my favorite RS models. The green one and the white one. Very cool. I like this look of RS's, except this one's only had the front wheel drive. And yeah, speaking with the owner, he said that the four wheel drive was also very fun to drive, but yeah, it's also very special four wheel drive system, not your standard four wheel drive system. Maybe the gold finish on the brakes, all the changes like the stickers on the side, full blacked out windows. Then, like I was just saying, on the RS500, normally this part is closed and the owner put some extra verkoeling in there to cool the brakes in the front and the extra Mount Tune cooler yet installed. So yeah, cool differences. I like the white color with all the black detailing. Nice RS spoiler, big exhaust. You can see these are the more standard exhausts, I think. The RS500 owner had some other exhaust put on top, which didn't look that standard. Then This green one also had a lot of changes done to it. Like you can see, most noticeable is of course the spoiler, full bespoke. Like the name says, spoiler. With an extra level in to create a lot of downforce. Then other exhaust system, of course. Also like this green color, very bright green. The silver wheels. Also some green on the seats. Of course, the Recaro seats. Very cool. Even on the Pocono, if you see the green detailing. It's a 6-speed manual, it says. Then take a look on this engine bonnet. We see the AirTech Motorsport. Also mount tune performance kit. You can see here we have some of the specs. 328 horsepower, top of 278 kilometers an hour, 0 to 100 only 5.6, yeah, which is not bad at all. Very cool looking cars. You just see the AirTech extra cooling system. Yeah, very nice. We'll go further. Then we'll continue the tour of the RS's. Another focus RS here. You can see the air intakes, a lot of air intakes going on in the front. Also other style of wheels, which I like. That they switch a bit of the things to make it their own car, to make it unique. Change maybe the color, change some parts, or just the wheels even. Yeah, to make it a bit special. Even if you have a regular Focus. Yeah, it's cool to put some tuning on it. To give it a sporty look like this. I did the red car, some black detailing. Not that much changed. Little back, like the side skirt and the front lip and the back lip, yeah. Which make a total new look to that car. Almost gives it a look like the RS. Then you have this ST, look also the latest Fiesta ST that you can see on the headlights. And this owner also went for the rally look. Did some not standard wheels, also not the big design of wheels to keep the rally look. Cool. Recaro seats, that's some striping. If you take a look on the rear, you can see also a full new diffuser and yeah, also a full new exhaust system. Yeah, very cool. Then this all new look by Miltech. Also the same diffuser, I think, as that car. It's cool that you have a diffuser that, yeah, really matches with exhaust. That you can't even see it, that it's aftermarket. So good done to those guys. Also a new side skirt and things like that. Very cool. See even the radiator from MS80, it says. Very cool tuning compared to the more regular ST. Next to it, you can see, yeah, the car has changed quite a lot. Then another cool car is this one. Very special wrap over it. Very cool with the ST in it. Very special. Also new design of wheels. New front lip. Even for a station car. Gives a full new look to it. Very cool. Then another ST, I think. This is the ST line more, but yeah, that's a sporty look to it with the new front lip, full new side skirt. Yeah, like the tuning cars also. The two exhausts to give a bit of a sporty sound. Another Focus here. This one also with a very aggressive look given to it. Very cool wheel design, more of a grey look. Then the car next to it, also had a full, yeah, full tuning done. Like you can see, not only the engine bay has a full new look to it, but like you can see the whole car, the new front bumper, even some flicks on the side, some fiber flicks, which look quite nice. Some LED lights inside, full new
bumper front light can see with some carbon fiber. A lot going on. Extra carbon fiber lip even. Very nice. Also the gold wheel design. Very special design of wheels. Forged wheels, it says. Very nice. And then, like, you see a lot of carbon fiber put on the car. Like the side skirt, even these. The mirrors. The pillars. Everything nice. Carbon fiber finished it. Even the interior has some racing details that you can see. Very nice. If we come to the rear, of course, sporty. Spoiler, and yeah, to not that standard exhaust, I think it's titanium, the material of the exhaust. Very nice. Also the very special bespoke diffuser that you can see with the leveling to create some downforce. Very cool car. Even the wiper has a carbon fiber finished with. And this is also a very special car, the Ford RS Cosworth. Real collector's Ford. The Sierra RS Cosworth, it says. The big exhaust. The rally car from back in the day. You can see with a very special design of wing. Also the white wheels. Cool. Race inspired, four-point racing balance this car has. Very cool. And the old school fabric seats, then with the four-point racing belts. Very nice. And if you take a look on this engine compartment, you can see built by Carmet Motorsport Cosworth. Very cool. Let's see this engine, legendary engine. En ja, de course old look to it on the front, but yeah, very cool looking car still. This is also very cool looking Ford. Really like the old rally looking cars of Ford. With the air outlets on the bonnet. And other cool things. Also a little spoiler. Create some downforce of course. Very cool. Another cool red Focus. So it's some tuning done to it. Nice. Then other Fiesta here. The Hoonigan, it says. Very cool. With also a new lip. The front, new wheel design. A bit lowered also, I think. Very cool. So the pinstripe on the diffuser and then a Karpovich exhaust. It is always nice for some sound. Then this is also from Car Ford. Special wheels to it. And that is also a special looking car. I think it's a Fiesta RS Mall, it says. I think this owner has made his own RS Fiesta. Because normally you don't have an RS model on the Fiesta. Yeah, like you can see, this owner went for a full new look to it. The exhaust, big exhaust. Yeah, very sporty, full painted everything. So the more enlarged wheel arch, so I can see some extra cooling going on. Then the latest in this line is the Fiesta ST. Very cool Fiesta ST also. The fully new body kit on it. Like you can see, a new spoiler with an extra fin on top. More standard look of the diffuser, but like you can see, those flicks aren't standard. And then the full new side skirt, also new look to it. And the Ford, also painted, I think. Not standard wheels. Very cool. New lip to it. Yeah, and we'll go further. Very cool cars here. Something else, normally we see cars that you almost can't afford. And yeah, sometimes it's just nice also to see some sporty cars, some hatchbacks that we can actually dream of and eventually buy one day ourselves. Then we have another Escort RS Cosworth here. Very special model with a special spoiler. You can see the rally car look to it. The extended wheel arches, the cooling on the side, very cool wheel design. Here a quick look on the inside, quick glimpse. Ricardo seats, Very cool, de air outlets on the engine bonnet. Ah, oké, super. You can maybe also take a look on the inside. The owner said. Nice. Look on the interior. Cool. Old school look. Even the gray seats with the support on the side. Very cool. The 5-speed manual. You can see the RS badge. Very cool. The 260, it says. 6,500 RPMs. Very fun car, I think, to drive. And all the turbo bar meters on the Cosworth. Very cool car. Even the rear seats. Nice sunroof. Yeah, very cool. Kijk, a quick glimpse on the interior. Very cool. Yeah. Sparty looked good. And another old Ford next to it. The rally car, the Escort, back in the days, also with extended wheel arches. This one in a very cool two-tone. The white on top and the blue on the side. Very big fog lights, like you have on the rally cars. This is a cool car, I think. To take on a nice old-timer rally. It'll make a nice sound also, I think. Very cool design of wheels. Cool. Old school interior, which I quite like. Old school cars, nice smell inside. Nice vintage look to it. Also a Escort, or as it says. The Mexico, very cool. Another Sierra Cosworth. Even drove the Rally of Monte Carlo, it says. Which is quite special to have here. With all the nice rally stickers. Nice. RS sound on the background. Yeah, echt a real rally livery. This car has also in the two-tone. Quite special. And if you continue, you see a nice camper of Ford. Very cool, old-timer, old-school pick-up look of the Ford. Just quite cool. These two, the old rally car and the old pick-up truck. A nice big grill. Simple lights. You can see, so basic, but still so cool. The side mirrors are extended quite wide. Even the rusty look to it doesn't matter. Pretty basic interior, nice rusty. Back, I like this color car, very cool. You have another Fiesta ST here, also a bit lowered, extra side skirt, full new front lip. It's a nice carbon fiber engine cover. I think it's also a new filter this car is, very cool. New turbo. The design of wheels and the cool design of headlights. It's also more darker light design. And we have another ST Fiesta here. Oh, it's nice to see the new turbo they put in and the new filter. This is also a very cool car, old school Ford Mustang, I think from the 60s or 70s. This looks like it's almost new, very good condition this car. Nice V8, nice filter on top, old school Ford V8, you can see not that much going on, but yeah, I think this car had a full new restoration, because like you can see all the chrome and everything, looks brand new. Only redone, also the paint looks like it's almost new. Full new paint job, it also had, I think, nice air outlets on the bonnet. Also, the chrome on the side of the car continues. Very cool look to it. Nice car. Then the steering wheel is also very known. The big Mustang steering wheel. Very cool, the clusters. Old school look of the clusters. And these shapes of the very known, recognizable shapes of the Mustang, that even the other owners like on the Fiestas and the Focuses. Come on the rear. Quick look on the rear. See the nice two exhausts on each side. Nice V8 sound, old school. rear lights, where of course the new inspiration comes from, the GT in the middle, very cool, Mustang, nice car. This most car on the line has a rally look to it, but yeah, I think he already went rally driving, which is quite nice. Then, if you walk further in the lineup of Fords here, we have a very special tuned ST. You can see it's put almost to the ground, or on the ground even. Very cool design of lights, special look, full new grille, very aggressive grille. The Panda look, the white and black, very nice. The OZ racing wheels, nice side skirt. And the roll cage, nice purple roll cage on the interior, very cool. A nice extended spoiler, aggressive spoiler. And two very big exhausts, of course, onder hier. Very nice. And then you can see the wheels are a bit put to the side. Which have an extended look to it, which makes it very special. Then another Cosworth here. Nice roll cage inside. Very cool. Like the old race cars, old rally cars of the Ford. Very special. A lot of arm takes. Even hier underneath the lights. An extra arm take. Very cool. And we have on the other side the Mondeo. Fully tuned Mondeo, full blacked out. Also lowered. Some skirts. And a nice station wagon of the Mondeo. Nice wheels. En also a full new bumper hier on this. Or on this Focus. Very cool. This car has the painted body light. You can see the painted side skirt and the painted front lip. Most of the cars have them in black. That you can see on this car. And sometimes the painted look is also good. This is also the latest Fiesta, like you can see on the headlights. Quick look on the rear. Nice rear. And the blue car also has a very special rear. Also with the special diffuser and the big exhaust. Even because, even if it is an EcoBoost, yeah, the extra exhaust will also make some cooler noise, of course. And this car has a more bronze look of wheels, rose gold. On over the black, which looks quite nice, I think. Also a special detail. This Fiesta ST, very special, nice looking car this one, also with some big exhausts on each side, very cool. Then we have another yellow car here, yellow Fiesta ST or Focus ST, I'm sorry, the latest Focus ST, but like you can see, if you put another diffuser on, and you put some big exhausts, you can create a RS look for yourself. And what I like on the latest Focus are the rear lights, which I like quite much, the rear lights. I don't know why, they have a nice good look to them. Some carbon finish on the interior, the Recaro seats, the center console also finished in carbon. Pretty cool, special yellow color. Is the new headlight design and the full black, gloss black wheels. And if we continue, we have the station model of the latest Focus ST. And I think this owner has not gone for the LED headlights. But yeah, I like the aggressive look, the new diffuser of cars on the new front bumper. Also the more matte finish on the silver matte. Finish on the wheels, no side skirt or anything aftermarket like you can see on this car, which is also sometimes nice. You have the ST, but yeah, I was wrong. He has gone for two very big exhausts. Of course, yeah, if you have a Ford EcoBoost, you will have some noise, but yeah, the extra exhaust system will of course create much better sound, much more aggressive, nice pops and bangs. Very cool, all the cars hier park next to each other. Then you have another Fiesta ST hier. The more grey look to it. Also the more standard Not that much done to it. Even a nice tuned Kuga here. Some cool finishes like the special wheel design and the side skirt. Some nice details like this painted above the headlights to give more aggressive headlight. Even the mirrors, special look to it. And if you go further, you have this focused station with a cool Mustang racing stripes over needed special design of wheels even. Action wheels, yeah, quite like these design of wheels, very aggressive. And if you go further, you have another very cool tuning car like you can see. Not your normal Focus. I think this is also the latest Focus. I can see a full new front lip, aggressive front lip. Even the grill here in the radiator is not standard, like you can see, a bit closed, but also with a new Magin steel line. And the extra air intake here to cool the front wheels, front wheel arches and brakes. Nice tech wheel design. Very cool, nice black side skirt in the car. And also cool extra spider lip. So you can see the painted part is the more standard and you put another level on top. Of course, so very much lower this car. But yeah, give an aggressive look to it. Then yeah, you have the Focus RS look even under here, like you can see. Even if it isn't a real RS with the nice diffuser and the two big exhausts, you can create the look for yourself. And yeah, it's a very good look, I think. Very aggressive new rear lights, very cool. And the last car I think in line is this Fiesta ST, and also a ST of S-Max van with the cool fog lights in the front, even a tow hook. Very cool. And we also have the Focus ST here, I think, with the two center exhausts on this model. Very special on this model that you have the two center exhausts. But yeah, I prefer the latest look of the rear lights. But yeah, this car is cool that they have the center exhausts and a nice lip on the rear and on the side of the car. Special wheel design. Very cool. Nice yellow color, and then, like I was saying, this even tuned van, the special wheel design. Yeah, very cool lineup here at Vught Village. And yeah, if you are interested in the Vught Village or to come to a Vught event, go to their website, because they will be hosting a lot of events, a lot of Vught events, a lot of Vught clubs and Vught enthusiasts from Belgium come to those meetings. And yeah, I can see a lot of cool cars. Then we have some other cool tuning cars here in the center, fully lowered Fiestas with a full sound system and a very big sound system in this Fiesta. Cool, even the cabriolet, the street 4K, they call it, in ice. Then another Fiesta hier, very cool. En de latest car, denk ik, in the field is this V6 Vught. Also nice, very special design of wheels this car has. Nice purple finish in, very cool, the V6. Then I would love to thank you guys all for watching to this short video here at the Vught Village in Leopoldsburg. Hopefully I will be going to some other Vught events in the future, and yeah, also big thanks to all the friendly people here that said something to me. And yeah, a lot of cool fans here of Vught. A lot of cool cars, of course. Very big thanks to all of you for watching. If you're a big Vught fan, please leave a like and please subscribe on the channel. Because like I said in the beginning of the video, there will be coming a lot of more videos in the future. And yeah, see you in the next video, guys. Bye.